There is a new Data for Progress poll in the great state of Kentucky that really caught our eye yesterday. So first of all, they have numbers in the Democratic primary. Now, you'll recall the matchup here is basically against Charles Booker, who's a populist, insurgent, progressive sort of new leader. He's a state representative there versus Amy McGrath. So let's see where this poll puts them. Surprise, surprise, in spite of the fact that Amy McGrath will spend ultimately something like $30 million in this Senate primary, dwarfing Booker's spending, she is losing to him right now in this primary poll. This election happens, by the way, next week, this Democratic Senate primary. And I've been talking a lot about this here because, first of all, I'm obsessed with Kentucky. But second of all, it is such an interesting race. You have Amy McGrath, who's this total centrist, like, consultant creation. Chuck Schumer picked her for the race. Allegedly, they were talking to her about running even before she lost her congressional bid. She raises millions and millions of dollars from resistance Dems all across the country. 96% of her money comes from out of state. And you have Charles Booker, who jumps in and just takes off, especially right in this moment where he emerges. He comes from a working class background. He's experienced police discrimination himself. He talks about from the hood to the hollers, like uniting the struggling people in Kentucky together across geography and across race. And it looks like it is really working out for him right now. It's pretty astonishing.
It's incredible. And one of the best things about this is that you've seen Amy McGrath, just the perfect poll-tested candidate, $19 million, you were telling me, in the bank with campaign, and picked by Chuck Schumer, all of this. Well, now national progressives are actually getting up behind her. I think Elizabeth Warren and others jumped in the race to endorse her, endorse Charles Booker in the Kentucky Senate primary, Alison Lunder and Grimes, others. This has prompted one of the most hilarious responses I've ever seen from Amy McGrath herself. Let's put her statement up on the screen. She is saying, I'm not part of the political establishment. I've been an outsider my entire life. I have the support of real Kentuckians from across the Commonwealth. When it couldn't be more the opposite case. All of her money is coming from New York and Silicon Valley billionaires and financiers.
I believe she's raised more money from Massachusetts than she has from Kentucky.
There you go.
This is 96% from out of state, by the way.
This is a fake candidate. It's literally like it's like Chuck Schumer's arms that are ones moving her around. She still doesn't even have the political prowess to even pull it off. It's pretty embarrassing, I think, from all of this. And look, I am always a supporter. You know, even if, you know, I disagree with Charles on a lot, but I love seeing establishment candidates just get rocked because that is how we break the mold of this country and who controls what in the process.
Right. And I mean, just on this point, it's just patently absurd on its face that she's the outsider candidate when she was literally picked by the DSCC and Chuck Schumer. And by the way, look, Charles has won the backing of Bernie Sanders, of AOC, of now Elizabeth Warren, but he also has won the backing of lots, way more Kentucky state legislators than Amy McGrath has. So it's not just he's the candidate of the national left. He is also the candidate of Kentucky Democrats who have watched Amy McGrath basically fall on her face, trying to paint herself as a pro-Trump Democrat. That was another thing. And that was something that was also really interesting in this poll. Look, Charles Booker is an African-American man, young African-American man in a state that has, Louisville is the most segregated city in the country by some metrics, you know, ugly racial history there. And so there's been all this like racial undertones of like, well, he can't win with these like racial undertones right under the surface. The other thing that this poll showed is that he was actually polling better against Mitch than Amy was.
Yeah.
And so, you know, first of all, throw some of your stereotypes out of the window. Second of all, people really want someone who actually stands up for what they believe in, who's willing to articulate their principles, doesn't do some bizarre consultant speak about how they're more pro-Trump than Mitch McConnell. Like, that resonates with people. He also, they did favorability of McConnell, McGrath, and Booker. He was the only one of the three that had a net favorable rating. McConnell was underwater and McGrath was way underwater, in part because there are a lot of Democrats who have a negative opinion of her because of the way that she has run this race. Now look, I think it's still, obviously from the poll, is still very close. They've been doing a lot of mail-in balloting given the pandemic, et cetera. You know, some of what I'm hearing on the ground is that she feels like maybe she's banked enough votes before Charles really picked up momentum. Right. And so she could lose on election day and still pull this thing off. So I don't want to say that this is over. But look, if you're just looking at the numbers, if you're looking up at who the establishment lined up behind, Charles Booker should not have a chance. And right now, he is looking very, very strong.
You just love to see it, folks.
You love to see it. More Rising for you after this.